In this video, I'm going to show you how I fixed up a couple of thrifted items. And if you buy things from the thrift store, you can use DIY paint and fix it up and it becomes amazing. You will really like the results. If you need any DIY paint or IOD products, please visit my website at thepaintedphotographer.com. I hope you enjoy this video. Hey everyone, welcome back. So I'm going to show you my thrifted items and tell you what I paid for them. And then they're available on my website. This tray was $1.97 and it has ceramic tile in blues and creamy whites on the bottom with this really dark wood. I like when I pick things up that have this dark wood because when you distress down to it, it's really pretty. It saves you a step. So that'll get painted up. I have these green bottles. This one came with a piece of tape on it because this cork does not stay in. I do think these are really cute. They're 97 cents. They're a pretty green color. So there are three of them. And they look really kind of cute in a set of three. That's how I will sell them, is in this set of three. I have this mail holder. It has a chalkboard that you can remove. It has some hangers. It's the flat back, so you can put it on the wall. And then it also has this like grid spot here. It does not remove, but it does have some screws, so I can remove it, put something fun underneath there. It has this little spot for a tag, which would be cute to put like the word mail or stuff in here, and then it has a nice slot for shoving your mail in there or your cell phones or iPads, whatever you choose. And you can put a little message on this chalkboard here, or it can be permanently adhered something in there, maybe an IOD paint inlay. Maybe that's what I'll do. Follow along and you can see how I fix this up. I have this green plastic urn. It was 97 cents. It does not have any drainage hole in the bottom. So you would have to put some rocks in there or use faux foliage to put something in here. This would be really nice in a concrete look versus this plastic look. It would be not breakable if it is the plastic and still had that concrete look to it. So I'm gonna paint this up and make it look like concrete. Here is a wood planter. It's on a pedestal. I remember these, they used to put fruit in them or set them on the table with real fruit, plastic fruit. This was 97 cents. It does have the felt on the bottoms of it. It is a really nice dark wood color and it does have a floral foam pad of some sort in here. I will try and get rid of that and get that out of there. Sometimes that glue, when it's really old, it is hard to get out of there, but I will try my best. And then I'm going to paint this and make it look like something else. Here's a bunny. I didn't know that. I did like the white bunny with the pink eyes, but I didn't realize that this eye right here had a chip out of it. So I'm gonna try and fix that up. And it was 37 cents, I suppose, because of the chip. It does have this pink bow on it. I'll probably take that pink bow off. I'm not sure if I'll paint this or if I'm just going to fix that little eyeball there. One, it does have a stamping on the bottom. And he just is really sweet. And a butter dish. I like stoneware like this, and this is a nice butter dish. It holds one full stick of butter, maybe even two, and it's stoneware, so it's nice and heavy. I do like this look, so you can either use it for your butter, you can use it as a soap dish in the bathroom, or put some pretty soaps in it, or you can put it on your table and put something else inside of it as well. That's all for my thrift haul. Now I'm gonna fix a few of these items up and show you what they look like.
We're gonna use the Farm Fresh on this bowl candlestick. And this is DIY paint, so you're just gonna put one or two coats on. This does cover very well, but it does have a dark surface underneath, which this one needed two coats. Then we took the IOD mixing white ink on an ink pad and stamped up this textured wallpaper that I sell on my website. And we just made a pattern on the top of that bowl in this white ink. The DIY paint distresses with water before you seal it, so I just took a baby wipe and rubbed off some of the paint on the higher spaces and gave that candlestick bowl holder a nice, pretty distress down to that beautiful dark wood. DIY has a product called paint frosting, and you can add it into a colored paint and stir it up. It just takes a very, very tiny bit, and you're going to stir that up and let it sit, and it's going to thicken as it sits. It sat for a while, and so now I'm taking it and adding it to this planter, and I'm giving it like a stippled look just because I want some crevices and valleys, and I want this to look like concrete planter versus a green plastic one. So I actually just take my brush and pounce, causing it to have a bunch of texture. With that paint frosting, it is really a dream. Now we're going to use Farm Fresh, and we're going to dry brush on this planter. So you put some paint on your brush, wipe it off on a piece of cardboard, and then you're going to dry brush over top, and it's only going to hit the high spots and give you a lot of depth in your item. A concrete planter always has a white look to it, so I'm going to use crinoline and go back over and dry brush with some crinoline to give it that white washed aged look. I've been really loving the making powders lately, and so I just dipped my brush in plain water and then into the orange Euglad paint powder, and I went ahead and I just added it to the rim of this planter, squirted it with water, and let that orange run down the planter, giving it a rusty kind of look. I continued and used a baby wipe to smooth some of those areas out, and then I even went in with the making powder called Pool Party, which is a really pretty turquoise color, and did the same thing. I like the dark wood of this platter, but I also do like the white and the blue look on the tiles that are in the inside. So I took Bohemian Blue and went over top of this dark wood in the Bohemian Blue to get that dark blue color from the tile, and painted the entire tray in this color and let it dry. I can also see blue iris in these tiles, so I went over and kind of dry brushed a really heavy dry brush over top with this blue iris and had the two-tone. Then I took a baby wipe and distress back down to that beautiful dark wood and sealed it up. I added mermaid tail also because I thought that I seen that in the tile as well, and it really added a lot. This mail slot holder, I used Farm Fresh and did one coat of Farm Fresh and decided I was going to put this rose chintz paint inlay on the front of it underneath this grate. So I was trying to find the best placement for the rose chintz, and I ended up cutting on all the lines so that I could have it on the face of this box and place it in the correct spot. So it does have grid lines that you can cut on, which are extremely helpful, so that you cut your lines straight and all you need is one measurement and you can finish cutting the entire thing. So I went ahead and I put a layer of paint onto the box, and you want to make sure that the paint is wet. So once you get that paint wet, you're going to make sure that you have a really good coat of paint on there. Then lay that paint inlay on top, and you got a little bit of time to move it, not much, but then you go ahead and spray it with water, and using this brayer really helps to get that paint inlay to sink into that paint that's underneath it. So if you don't have a paint brayer, it's a good investment. After it dries, you're going to take the water bottle and you're going to soak it again, and that releases the paper from the paint, and you peel it back, and this is extremely satisfying to watch this paint inlay come off on your item. So I gave you an up close look at that, and then I also put it over the entire box because I did like it so much. Is it an A? Feels like a heavy burden. This is the second time using this paint inlay. You can use the paint inlays 2, 3, 4 times. You just get a more vintage look every time that you use it. So this is the second time, so it is not as bright as when I used it the first time, but I really do like that vintage look. And I went ahead and put a sealer onto this box, and then I took dark wax, and I added the dark wax to the edges of this. I had sanded it because I want it to have a more worn look, because that transfer or that inlay was worn as well. So you just put the dark wax on. As long as you have a sealer on there, it'll come off and you'll be able to move it around a lot better with a dry piece of paper towel. And this gave it a real vintage look, and it's just amazing. I do love the transformation on this wood box with sanding it after it was done, and then adding that dark wax, and then adding the hardware back onto the box. It really made a statement.
It's like we're running in circles,
going around every day. Getting stuck in
this bunny I had to fix up with the IOD clay, and he had a little chip by his eye there, and so I just went ahead and put a spot of wood glue inside the chip area, and then I took the IOD clay and I put it on top and kind of formed it to how the eyelid would look if it had not been chipped. And I let that dry, and all I did was add some big top to it because it kind of matched pretty well. So I added some big top to it, and this bunny is all fixed up.
When your projects turn out looking like this, then you know that DIY paint is some amazing stuff. Follow me on Facebook and Instagram for more ideas on what I do with thrifted items. Also, if you haven't subscribed, please do so. It really helps my channel. I am Connie from The Painted Photographer, and until next time, happy painting. DIY paint. IOD products, sold at thepaintedphotographer.com.